why we are still on the subject of faith. Remember we said faith is believing in things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. We pray and we believe and we wait upon the Lord. However, while waiting upon the Lord, what do we do? Do we sit still and not do anything and fold our arms? No. While we wait upon the Lord, we do what is physically and naturally possible to do. Like when you're sick, you go to the doctor, you get your prescription, you take your medication. But while taking your medication, you believe God for a complete healing. If you're looking for work, you don't sit at home and fold your arms, you go out there and you look for opportunities. If you believe God for a breakthrough in your business, you work hard. You don't just sit and pray. Because faith without works is dead. I'm going to read the book of James chapter 2 from verse 14. Verse 14. What good is it, my brother, if a man claims to have faith but has no deeds? Can such faith save him? Suppose a brother or sister is without clothes and daily food. If one of you says to him, go, I wish you well, keep warm and well fed, but does nothing about his physical needs, what good is it? In the same way, faith by itself, if it is not accompanied by action, is dead. Verse 21. Was not Abraham considered righteous for what he did when he offered his son Isaac on the altar? You see that his faith and his actions were working together, and his faith was made complete by what he did. And the scripture was fulfilled that said, Abraham believed God, and it was credited to him as righteousness, and he was called God's friend. Verse 26. As the body without the spirit is dead, so faith without deeds is dead. Verse 24. You see that a person is justified by what he does and not by faith alone. Therefore, our faith must be accompanied by our actions, because faith without works is dead. Hashtag